Hello everyone, my name is AP Nishad Begum, working as lecturer in Abhaya Group of Institutions, Bangalore. So today let's do a low vision workup and the patient is here. So this video I'm shooting for Indian Academy of Optometry, in which I'm doing a low vision specialization. So let's start the low vision workup. So before starting the low vision workup, you should be thorough with the history taking. So before history taking, you see the patient how he is walking inside the clinic, his head poster, with whom he accompanied, and how he walks inside the clinic. This is very, very important. Then you can ask his name, age, sex, hobbies, and address, and with whom he accompanied by, causes of low vision, then visual history, medical history, family history, birth history, and then his education and profession. Then also you should ask like whether he is driving or not, what all tasks he does for the distance and near visual acuity tasks, and whether he have any problem seeing the faces, watching TV. All this you have to record. Other than this, you have to record for specific need of a low vision patient, that is for the distance and for the near. Then after that, you can perform a visual acuity, retinoscopy, contrast sensitivity checkup, color vision checkup, Amsler grid, visual field, all this functional vision assessment you can do after this. So let's begin. Hello sir, good afternoon. Sir, your name?
Suresh.
Your age?
62 years.
This patient is already diagnosed with ARMD and referred to this clinic. And he also have a family history of ARMD. So what is the specific complaint you visited here, sir?
I don't see, the prescription or what, some small...
Okay, small letters are difficult letters for you. Okay, sir. Other than this, any difficulty, sir?
That's what, like description and all, and some medicines, for example, like signature also sometimes.
Okay, okay. Your profession, sir?
I'm a lecturer in...
College. You are a lecturer. Okay, so you are a lecturer and you do near vision tasks.
Yeah, some reading and all that.
Okay. Your hobby, sir?
Reading and traveling.
Okay, reading and traveling. So nice. Okay, sir. So other than this, you don't have any difficulty. You have only difficulty seeing the small prints in the small letters, like in expiry dates, MRP.
Yeah,
can you see?
No.
That is also difficult?
Yeah.
So bank related work you are doing, sir, anything that also you have?
Bank only, that means signature sometimes.
Okay.
I have to do that.
Okay, signature and checkbooks.
Checkbooks.
That is difficult. Okay, sir. So other than this, you don't have any problem, right?
Not much. Yes.
Okay, you do driving, sir?
No.
No, you don't do driving. Let's do his visual acuity checkup. Can you please lift this? Are you comfortable? Is this comfortable for you?
Yeah.
I have closed your one eye, sir. Please lift one eye. Can you please see the chart?
Yeah.
Can you read the first letter?
A.
A. Second letter, sir?
X.
Okay, then down next one.
Not much yet, yeah.
You try to read, sir. It is difficult.
Yeah, difficult. T and not very
good. Not clear. Okay, sir. I have placed one small hole.
Yeah.
So with that hole, can you see?
Yeah, I can see.
You can see?
Yeah.
What is that?
T, V, H.
Okay, next to that?
U, A, X.
It's difficult or it is clear?
That one is clear, but below that it is little merging.
It is merging. Okay, sir. Thank you. Similarly, let's see for his other eye. Sir, can you read the first letter?
A.
The next letter?
X.
No. Next one, it is difficult for you. I'll put again a hole in front of your eye. With that, can you see?
Yeah, only A on top. X below and O, that's all.
Down in one.
Down are not difficult to.
With the hole also, it is not improving,
yeah,
right? Okay, sir. Can you please hold this for the ear? As you hold your newspaper that distance, can you hold this? Bend your wrist. write at least in 1-2 words you can tell? No? Yes sir?
Yeah,
but
age.
Above this it is difficult,
yeah,
right?
Difficult.
Okay, so with this sign, till where you can read?
Then you can say my second line I can't. First one I can read.
You can read, please read it.
Age of.
It is difficult?
Yeah.
It is difficult?
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thank you. One second. Now, after his visual acuity, near and distance, we have to check for his contrast sensitivity. Let's take him to the Penny-Robson chart. Now, let's do his contrast sensitivity checkup by using Penny-Robson chart. Sir, can you please close one eye?
Yes.
Can you read this, sir?
V R S K D R N H C S O K, slightly difficult. S O.
You can't see here.
N O Z V. Difficult. Difficult. Something is there. C I think or O. I'm not sure.
Difficult.
Yeah. Difficult. H. Difficult.
Okay. No problem. Can you please close the other eye? With this, can you read again?
Yeah, V R S K D R N H C S O K S O N O Z V. Slightly again difficult.
Difficult.
Yeah.
No problem. You can't see anything in this, right?
Yeah.
You try it again.
Merging.
No. Thank you, sir. Let's do now a confrontation checkup. For this, you and the patient should be seated into the same eye level. Then you can suggest the patient to close one eye. Sir, please close one eye. Sir, now you are also closing your eye and you can give target as your nose. So please see here. I'll be showing you some numbers around here and you have to tell whatever number you are seeing. Shall I start, sir?
Okay.
Yeah. This?
2 1 4 3.
Don't move your eyes.
I can't see that.
You can't see that?
My hand is in.
No.
3.
No.
1.
No.
2.
Okay, close the other eye. Keep looking here at my nose.
2. 1. 1. 1. 2. 1. 2. 3. 2.
Yeah. Now, after the confrontation test, we have to do for the answer grade checkup. So, let's do that. Sir? Here, let's see for the answer grade checkup. Sir, can you please see this dot?
Yes, I can see.
Can you see these four borders, sir?
Yeah, I can see.
Can you please see these check boards? Are they straight or little they are wavy?
They are little wavy.
They are wavy this side or this side, sir?
On both sides they are.
Little wavy?
Wavy?
Okay, close the other eye, sir. Can you please see this dot?
Yeah, I can see the dot.
Can you see these four corners?
Yeah.
Can you see these checkerboards? Are they straight?
No, they are little wavy.
Where, sir? Here, where the wavy are?
Yeah, all.
All the sides, yes. It is wavy?
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Let's do collaboration checkup. low vision optical and non optical aids along with the accessory aids. So let's see here. And a patient is having complaint like seeing near vision and seeing the checkbook where he has to sign, all the problems. Now we are coming to the important part of low vision assessment, that is to prescribe them optical, non optical and the accessory low vision devices. So if we can see here, here we have a flexible arm task lamp, that is for extra lighting, and we have this bump dots for the locating purpose, and large clocks. We have the bold line papers, typoscopes, signature guides, writing guides, notex to identify the money, reading stand, pinhole glasses, filters. So all these are low vision, yes, non optical and accessory low vision. So your complaint is like for difficulty in seeing the near print, near objects and signing in the checkbook. So you can use this, sir. This is a signature guide. You can use this in your checkbook, and if this space is there, right, here is where you will be signing. So it will be easy for you to. So if example, this is your checkbook, then you can keep like this. Yeah, you can keep, then you can sign. You can sign within this region. So that will be like particularly you are signing into that region, into your checkbook. So if you are reading also or to write, because as you are a lecturer, you are a professor, so you may do more of near task. So you can keep this letter writer and you can just flip on like this. Yeah, in between these lines, you can use a stand and you can continue writing here. So that you will be having a very perfect writing along with the best. And also, if you feel like I cannot hold for a long time, you can use a stand. Then you can fix it there. So other than this, your complaints have to see the MRPs. So whenever you are going for the shopping, you can use this pocket magnifier. This is very small pocket magnifier. So you can use this. You can carry this whenever you are going. And you can use to see small letters. Yeah. You can just do up and down like this.
Yeah, adjust.
Yeah, you can adjust. You can focus it. Can you locate?
Yeah.
Yeah, like this. If you want a little bigger also, we have the pocket magnifier. Yeah. Can you hold this? To see the MRPs, to see the expiry dates, you can use this. You can just do like this, where it will get autofocus if you do like this. Up and down. Yeah. Then you can locate the MRP and expiry dates. And the larger prints or the books, newspaper, if you are reading for longer duration, you can use a handheld magnifier. Okay. This also depends on how you do the focusing. Can you read it? Can you please focus any letter and try reading it?
Yeah. I can read some lenses.
Yeah, next to that?
No.
Yeah, you can read. So if for a longer duration, if you want to read, if you can't hold it, then you can use this. You can use this. This is a stand magnifier. You can place it and little, you can just come forward and you can see, and you can just slide like this, slowly, slowly. For a longer duration of reading, like your hobby is reading, you can use this. For a less duration, you can use a hand magnifier. For the MRP scenario, you can use a pocket magnifier. And you don't do any driving movements. Yeah. Like this, you want to access a low vision patient, and after that, whatever the complaint the patient says, you want to fulfill and you want to give them low vision aids, optical, non optical, and accessory aids also. Then only your low vision assessment is completed after the pre clinical evaluation. So, this is all about the low vision assessment.